Hi students, before in the topic of refraction of light at plane surfaces, we already discussed about the glass slab activity, and again I already given some of the definitions of incident ray, refracted ray, emergent ray, angle of incidence, angle of refraction, angle of emergence, the surface angle, and various topics I already given. Now from that activity, what we understood is speed of the light changes depending upon the media. Speed of the light is not constant, speed of the light changes from medium to the medium. That means speed of the light, in some cases of the media speed of the light is more, in some media the speed of the light is less. If you observe here, speed of the light in air or vacuum represented by letter C, whose value is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. In ice, 2.29 × 10⁸ meter per second. Water, 2.25 × 10⁸ meters per second. If you compare water and glass, speed of the light in water with respect to speed of the light in glass. Water speed of the light is 2.25 × 10⁸ meter per second. In the glass is 2 × 10⁸ meter per second. That means speed of the light in water is more as compared to the speed of the light in the glass. Now water is said to be rarer medium, that is optically rarer medium when compared to speed of the light in the glass. Now the glass is said to be optically denser medium. Once again you compare the ruby and diamond. Now the ruby becomes optically rarer medium, whereas well as a diamond becomes optically denser medium. These are all I already discussed before, optically rarer medium and as well as optically denser medium. If we consider among all these given values, air is said to be completely, first of all, optically rarer medium. Here, we understood that speed of the light is different in different cases. Now, I am going to compare the speed of the light in air, that is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second, with respect to the speed of the light in the glass. Why? Because we did in the case of air to glass, in that glass have activity, that is 2 × 10⁸ meter per second. By cancelling meter per second and 10⁸ and as well as 10⁸, we got a value, that is 3/2, whose value is equal to 1.5. This numerical value is called absolute refractive index of glass with respect to air. Once again, what we are calling absolute refractive index of glass with respect to air. In CBSE curriculum, it is represented as mu GA, that is nothing but absolute refractive index of glass with respect to air. Once again, if you observe one more example, 3 × 10⁸ meter per second is nothing but speed of the light in air or vacuum with respect to the water, that is 2.25 × 10⁸ meter per second. By cancelling meter per second and meter per second, and at the same time 10⁸ and as well as 10⁸, we got a numerical value 3/2.5, that is equal to 300/225 by multiplying with 100/100. Now we got around the approximate value is 1.32. This is nothing but absolute refractive index of water with respect to air. Absolute refractive index. Absolute refractive index. What is this absolute refractive index represented by letter N, or otherwise represented by letter mu? Now N is equal to C/E. That means it is the ratio of speed of light in air or vacuum with respect to the speed of the light in a given medium.
speed of the light in air or vacuum to the speed of the light in a given medium. This means absolute refractive index n is equal to c by e. If this indicates, that implies nga is equal to speed of the light in air by velocity of the light in the glass, or otherwise n, if you consider ruby with respect to air, ruby with respect to air, that is n r a, that is equal to velocity of light in air by velocity of light in the ruby. Now we can get absolute refractive index of the ruby. Once again, what is the definition of absolute refractive index? It is defined as the ratio between speed of light in air to the speed of the light in the given medium. It is represented by letter n or otherwise mu. Now, what are the units of that? If we consider here, we cancel the units. Whatever it may be the units, either it may be in CGS system or otherwise MKS system, we cancelled the units. That means we got a simply a numerical value. So refractive index is a mere number. It is a simply numerical value. It does not have any units. It is a dimensionless quantity. Means a dimensionless quantity which is a ratio of speed of light in air or vacuum to the speed of light in a given medium is said to be absolute refractive index, represented by letter n or mu, which does not have any units. Exactly, perfectly, we can say absolute refractive index is a fundamental property of a transparent material. Means whatever it may be a transparent material is there, compulsory it contains absolute refractive index. Let us discuss now one more concept, that is nothing but relative refractive index. Relative refractive index. Now see here, I am going to compare speed of the light in glass by speed of the light in water, that is VW, that is, or otherwise you can take in the reverse direction. For example, say if you are observing like this, here a glass tumbler is there, inside water is there. This is a glass tumbler and inside water is there. For example, say if a light ray is traveling from air to glass and glass to water and again through glass. This means glass to water. Here we are going to consider the refractive index, means speed of the light in water, VW, by PG, water to glass, water to glass. Now that means what is the speed of the light in water? 2.25 into 10 power 8 meter per second by glass, that is 2 into 10 power 8 meter per second. By cancelling this, we got 2.25 by 2. By that is 2.25 by 2. 2 ones are 2. Once again, 2 ones are 2. 2 twos are 4. 1.25. We got relative refractive index of water. Relative refractive index of water with respect to glass. Relative refractive index of glass. Relative refractive index of glass with respect to water. That is nothing but Ng by Nw. That is nothing but Vw by Vg. Relative refractive index of glass with respect to water. Relative refractive index of glass with respect to water. For example, say I want relative refractive index of diamond with respect to glass. That is nothing but refractive index of diamond by refractive index of glass. That is equal to velocity of light in air by velocity of light in diamond, total divided by velocity of light in air by velocity of light in glass. By taking C by VD into VG by C, what we got final result? VG by VD. That is nothing but in the reverse ratio, NDG means relative refractive index of diamond with respect to glass is equal to refractive index of diamond divided by refractive index of glass. That is equal to VG by VD. Finally, we can prove that relative refractive index is defined as the ratio of refractive index of one medium with respect to the refractive index of another medium. Final conclusion, N21 is equal to N2 by N1, that is equal to C by V2 divided by C by V1. That implies C by V2 into V1 by C. By cancelling C and C, what we got finally? N21 is equal to N2 by N1 is equal to V1 by V2. For example purpose, I required refractive index of ruby with respect to sapphire, or otherwise ruby with respect to water. That is nothing but refractive index of ruby divided by refractive index of water. In the reverse ratio, it becomes velocity of light in water divided by velocity of light in ruby. One more example, if you consider relative refractive index of water and ice. Water with respect to ice, that is equal to refractive index of water divided by refractive index of ice. That is equal to, in the reverse process as per the formula, N21 is equal to N2 by N1. That is equal to V1 by V2. It becomes a velocity of light in ice by velocity of light in water. This is the basic concepts in the case of physics, that is absolute refractive index and as well as refractive index. Both absolute refractive index and as well as relative refractive index does not have units. They are simply a mere number, numerical values. This means they are dimensionless quantity. In the absolute refractive index, we are comparing the velocity of light of a medium with respect to air. In the relative refractive index, we are comparing the velocity of a medium with respect to velocity of light of one more medium. Here both of them are media only. In the relative absolute refractive index, one of the medium is air.